Well, African exploration and development company Aureus Mining is to raise more than $15 million. That equates to just over £10 million, and the cash is to fund development changes for its new Liberty mine in Liberia and to cover the costs of the Ebola crisis. Well, David Redding is the chief executive. David, talk us through the new optimized plan. What are the benefits relative to the existing DFS plan?
Yes, certainly. I think that we've lost a couple of months due to the Ebola crisis, and we certainly lost a little bit of money. But what the new plan does is it basically produces more ounces over the first 6 months now and over the year. So instead of the definitive feasibility study ounces of about 90,000, we're now producing 120,000 over the first 12 months. Obviously, that means stronger cash flow. The new mine plan is two starter pits instead of one. That gives us a lot more operational flexibility. We create a bigger stockpile. And so, generally speaking, this is a much stronger plan for, you know, the current gold price and allows the company to generate a lot more cash for, growth and for shareholders.
So, David, how critical is it that the price of gold remains at least stable near to midterm? Or is the predicted grade that you're mining for high enough to ensure profitability even at today's prices?
Well, I think the new plan is more robust at a $1,300 gold price than the old plan was at a $1,400 gold price. So it's certainly still robust at $1,250 gold. I think the other point I would make is that the western pit of two starter pits has grades running at 16 grams over 10 meters, so very high grade. So accessing more of this high grade early certainly gives us a big buffer against the gold price and a lot more flexibility.
So you said early there, David. You know, when can we expect production to start at New Liberty?
Well, first gold will be poured in the last 2 weeks of May, and then by July we should have reasonable steady state production from the plant.
Okay, now in terms of the money that's being raised, the IFC is one of the backers. What are the terms of the IFC's loan? When do they want repayment?
Well, this is equity, so it's not, it doesn't have to be repaid. We issued shares for this money. So the IFC is not given us debt. The South African banks have given us debt. What the IFC's done is increased its shareholding now to 14.5% in the company, which is a massive testament for the company to have the World Bank as such a large shareholder.
Thank you for that clarification. But going back to how I started the interview, the Ebola crisis has cost you. Do you anticipate any recurring costs if there is another significant outbreak?
Well, I think that the Ebola costs were a one-off thing because they were mainly related to shipments and delays in shipments. We now have all our equipment on site. I think the other thing I would say is that the Ebola crisis has diminished somewhat, and there are only 5 or 6 cases in the whole country at the moment. So, you know, that's a big step down from 300 cases a week in last November.
So is the key message in the most recent update from yourselves all about making up for lost time and essentially beating the rainy season in October?
Absolutely. I mean, this new plan not only allows us to produce more ounces in the first 12 months, it also allows us to produce more ounces in the first 6 months. It allows us to generate stronger cash flows. It gives us more operational flexibility, and it gives our shareholders and stakeholders the surety that we have an operational business now that can withstand, you know, changes in the gold price and any other unforeseen events.
And in terms of milestones, when shall we next be hearing from you?
Well, I think first gold pour, it's not that far away, and, you know, various other events such as completion of plant build, further blasts and mining. I think, you know, it's going to be a very busy year for Aureus in terms of announcements.
And we look forward to hearing from you. David Redding, Chief Executive of Aureus Mining, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you very much.